gonna try and jog and eat rice cakes like a boss. Storm.
This is so closer.
And it's like, ah, absolutely soaked, which maybe.
I think I'll go along path not maintained.
And it's, ah, oh, the cold water's on my balls.
Oh, look at that, so pretty. That is so pretty.
Oh my God, like this is total Ming Mong. It's kind of like a cozy blanket. Oh my God! Oh, lost my shoe! Ah.
You'd be like, what the hell have I just come across?
Guys, look at them! Oh my God, they smell so good.
No unauthorized person beyond this point.
Faster, go! Apart from that, you know, which is like, whoa, awesome! I have life again. Today I'm going to be doing a Highland half marathon. I'm going to be starting at Cairngorm car park, where the ski centre is, and then going all the way down, hopefully ending up in Kincraig, and it should be around about a 24 25 kilometre jog. However, this isn't like an actual race or anything like that. This is just me going for an adventure. And a lot of it, I have no idea where to go. Or I've lived around here or been up here for many years, but there's so many bits of it which I haven't done. I've just done the normal, usual walks. So this is going to be an interesting one. There's going to be about a good 12 to 15 kilometres of path which I have not run on. And the tricky bit is, a lot of the path is this. It's going to be this. So just now I'm just on my warm-up. It's about 10 o'clock in the morning, going for a warm-up, checking the weather, checking the temperature, checking my clothes I'm going to be wearing, listening to the birds, that's nice. But the paths are all very much like this. Trees on one side, trees on the other, path here. And the trees are so high, you can't even see the mountains. So if you're going around a corner, or you're going up a hill or something, you don't know if you're going exactly the right way, so I might actually have to bring a map on this one and actually figure it out. But yeah, so getting a warm up first, then home, breakfast, pile of stretching, maybe a shower, and then drive up to Cairngorm. So here are all the things I'm going to go for on the run. A very light Under Armour t-shirt, which I actually got from 2009 Survival of the Fittest. The shorts are ones with an inner lining, so I'm not going to wear any underpants. Sexy. This, a buff, for on my head in case it gets sunny, but also possibly over my eyes to keep the goddamn flies away. Food-wise, I'm going to take, I think there's only like 3 rice cakes in that left anymore, so that's 150 calories. Blueberries, 300 grams, that's still only about 100 calories, so I'm going to just smash as many of them before I get out of the car when I get there. A couple bananas. Now, running with bananas doesn't very work. They just become total mush, so I'd have to eat them pretty soon on. Water bottle. Annoyingly, I don't have a small water bottle, so I'm just going to have this, but then crunch it up. And just, I don't need all that water, and I'm sure there's a place where I could probably fill it up, maybe. Phone for GPS. GoPro for filming. And then I'm going to try and stick it all in this fairly light rucksack as well, X-Light, which is actually my girlfriend's. So that's the preparation. Oh, and also, yeah, most important, God, how did I forget, Avon Skin So Soft to keep the flies away. So I'm going to drown myself in that just now. Right, so that's me just being dropped off at the Cairngorm car park. Dad's just dropped me off, and look at the view I've got of total rain, which I'm going to be in. I'm ringing. Somebody's ringing me. Okay, so after that quick call, I'm starting. The height is 2,083 feet from what's called the Day Lodge, which is the starting point. And it is starting to rain now, so that's annoying. And I am going to be running straight into rain over there. So time to start the run. Oh, just went for a pee. Oh no, right, this is the first time I'm actually jogging with all the water, blueberries, banana, rice cakes on the back. So feels light enough, and having the extra straps around the chest, around the waist,
definitely helps support that. So hopefully this bit should be nice and quick and nice and downhill. However, tricky ground.
Well, this is totally not how I'd planned to start this. I'm just, just like 1 kilometer in, absolutely soaked, rain, just constant rain. Like, I'm always like, I hate, like, running in horrible weather. It's horrible. Why would you do that? And this is what I'm doing. Oh, and it's cold rain. It wasn't feeling too cold there, but the rain is cold, and it's absolutely soaked, which may be good actually, because my thighs feel a little bit numb. So they're gonna stay dry, or they're gonna stay feeling good. But camera's getting wet, phone's getting wet, might not have my GPS. Okay, this is all going very, very wrong. The cold water's on my balls. I'm gonna totally get sweaty balls, and this is gonna be painful. But again, still, like, look at that! Look at the view! It's awesome! But I just can't see it because all the bloody rain's in my eyes. I've just given up the idea of wearing glasses. Better to be slightly out of focus than misty, steamed up, and water in your eyes. But straight, very quickly, once you go up the hill, you're falling. Look at that, it's so pretty! That is so pretty. And if that was with some sunshine, that's it. Like, this is a place for photographers to come along and get shots of. So the first bit here is awesome. You totally feel like you're superhuman, and you're like, oh, I'm totally going to get like a personal best half marathon because it's all downhill. The other thing is, even if it was, or if you decided to go when it just stopped raining, you're still going to be soaking wet because you're running past trees which are wet, and my feet are soaking already just because of all the low level tree stuff that's already wet and just rubbing against your shoes, making you soaking wet. So yeah, be prepared for wet feet. Oh, now I'm into more of a forest. That's so cool. Right. Whew. 3.5 kilometers in, still going downhill, still feeling good. Rain's kind of stopped. Almost managed to see through my glasses now. But one thing I want to do now, after all that bouncing, is to find out what. Big puddles. That was a deep one. Find out what condition the food is and stuff in my rucksack. I don't even want to look at where my phone is because that is soaking wet. So let's have a look here. Okay, looking good. Let's see, blueberries. Looking okay. They're not seem to be dripping loads of stuff, but banana. Soft and squishy banana. So, plan is eat the banana while running downhill. Now that's lovely. Look at that. Look at just the clouds, just in the trees and the hills and stuff. That's what path I've come from. What I would say, just as I stop there, holy crap, see there's a heck of a lot of flies all around me. This buff, totally haven't noticed the flies because of this. So buffs, great for stopping you notice flies. Oh, Scotland, if you could just be like this all the time, apart from, check out the flies. Go away. Right, I need to run faster. I need to actually run faster. Go. Like, I drowned myself in Avon Skin So Soft to keep the flies away. I think it keeps the midges away, but all these little flies, which are everywhere. Let's see if I just stop for a second. Look! God! Yeah, Skin So Soft. Just get rid of them. I'd love to be able to tell you just now about the amazing views, the Loch Morlach over there, the mountains, the Cairngorms, and all that jazz. But just now, I'm just running at PB breaking speeds to get rid of, oh my god, look at them, they're all over me! To get rid of all these flies. My idea is run next to trees, run under branches like this one here, and hopefully all the flies just smack into it. Doesn't seem to be working though. I'm actually begging for the rain to come back. Go for it. So this is where I go into totally unknown territory. That is Loch Morlaich, that way is Aviemore, that way is Cairngorm. This is where all the flows are! And I'm going Larrigrue way, up this way, which never been this way, don't even know what it's like, don't know if it's hilly or not. All I hope is that there's something that kills flies. Right, I have to give myself some cognitive behavioural therapy, CBT, and what that is changing the words and the ideas that you use to describe things. So instead of me thinking, ah, these flies, it's like a horror film when I look around behind me, these flies are here to just annoy me. No, they're here to motivate me. Thank you, flies. Thank you so much. Yay. So this is where I'm having to go by road signs or path signs. So Piccadilly Larrigrue. Didn't know it was called Piccadilly. So now into the forest after that long path. Stopped a minute back there to go for a pee and the flies disappeared. Does pee have anti-fly properties? Or is it just the fact that I stopped for a minute? Oh, but either way, also randomly, when you're on these paths, you see these things. They're kind of all over the place. I think these are for, I can't imagine what they're for, if there's like a forest fire or something like that, to pat it out. I'd imagine that would just fan the flames. Don't know how well they work. Never seen them being used, but they are everywhere. Unless they're for something else. Are they ever used for something else? Like hitting anthills or something. Ah, yes. The rain is starting again. Like, legitimately happy about that. That's me. Just done 1 hour worth of, 1 hour worth of jogging. And I'm at 9.34 kilometers. So just under 10k, or 9.3 kilometers an hour. Not too bad, considering I don't know where I'm going. Now, one of you guys on my YouTube channel is saying, if you're running for more than an hour, definitely take water with you. I've got my water with me. So for the next kilometer or 5 minutes, to go to drink some water and have a rice cake as well. That'll do me for some energy until I get to Loch Annealan, which is the next bit. And there's quite a lot of cyclists on this path as well. So it's quite a popular place. The path to the Larrigrue really is not much of a path at all. It's just a tiny thing. So I'd actually say pretty well marked every kind of major junction. Rothie Market's path, please take later home. Aviemore, that way, Loch. Wait, what? No, yeah, I'm not going to Loch Morlaith. I'm going that way. No, I'm not even going to Aviemore. I'm going to Loch Annealan, which should be along this way. But yeah, I always think I'm on a downhill just now. If you can jog and eat at the same time, that's cool. So, I'm going to try and jog and eat rice cakes like a boss. Ah, this bit is lovely. This is a bit which I've never been down before. Again, lots of cyclists going past. They're fairly popular for cyclists, but I'm just following the river downstream, so gives you kind of the mental edge of going jogging downhill the whole time. But just I'm almost annoyed at myself for having been coming up to the Highlands for 30 years and not knowing about this path. It's lovely. You've got all your weird insect spawn in there. But also just look at that. And the water looks so clean here as well. However, the amount of flies that have been chasing me, I do not believe it's clean enough to drink. Well, disagree, yeah. Probably it's totally clean enough to drink. Mineral water. But I'll keep using the tap water at the moment, just in case. But yeah, lovely, lovely gentle path, easy for jogging, pretty much all downhill, makes you feel superhuman. No wind just now as well, and just the odd cyclist. The only downside, doesn't have any, like I've only seen one deer so far. That's it. Deer and flies. That's it.
Hello. Always say hello.
Finally, this is where the path splits. And I'm going to lock an eland. Well, I didn't tell you before there, they had a little secret stash of, was it round trees, wine gums, or fruit pastels with my extra energy. This stuff, these rice cakes, I reckon great, full of salt, full of carbs, full of yumminess. Definitely good for runs like this.
Oh, lovely.
So don't have quite as much to say on this jog as normal. Just it's lovely. I look at the little streams and little bridges made for you to cross over and all that. It's absolutely lovely, but it's kind of like a cozy blanket, you know? Once I love this, it's beautiful. But once you've said, oh, it's a lovely cozy blanket, there's not much else to tell about it. You just keep on enjoying it. So it's not as much like of my other videos where I'm like, oh, I've got to climb up this cliff and dangle off things and see weird statues and stuff like that. Actually, there might be some weird statues during this run. But it's just nice. It's just really nice. Apart from the flies. Yeah. Awesome. Just over 13 kilometers, I'm at Loch Anealan. So this is a place which I do, it's a lovely 5 kilometer walk around a loch, which has a ruin in the middle of it, which I'm gonna try and do a fly over at some point soon. But that's good, this is cool. I've never got here other than by car. So this is the first. The only thing is, at the far end of Loch Anealan, which is where we're going just now, there's another loch called Loch Gamma. It's not how it's spelt, but very interesting. And that, back into like, where the hell am I going zone. Right, at 14 kilometers, I think it's time for me to finally get into my blueberries, which are actually just turning into total blueberry goo just now. So I'm going to get through 300 grams of this before hitting Loch Gamma. But like, it's like, totally squished. Ah, oh, that did not just happen. Oh, my blueberries have just... I've been running with all these blueberries and that's all I've got left. It just fell out the pack. Oh, that's annoying. Very, very annoying. Now this is Loch Anealan, which looks awesome just now. Ah, look at the blue sky, the fluffy white clouds, and the calm water. And over there, look how clean the water is here. All super clean. Right there. There's an island with a little kind of ruin in the middle of it. And it's just a big Loch Anealan that goes all the way kind of around the corner there. And it's cool. You can just hear it because it is a proper like a 5k walking track around here. You just hear lots of families and people with children and dogs barking and stuff like that. It's really, really sweet little place to go for a walk if you're ever up in Kincraig, Aviemore area. Anyway, back onto the path. Now, this is where I go off track again. So, over there is Loch Gamma. I'm going to just call it Loch Gamma. Over there is Loch Anealan. The path, I don't think it's that, but there is another path here. Same path, not maintained. And my phone totally just like given up on trying to find any maps of this area. So I think I'll go along path not maintained. See what happens with that one. Ooh, I think I like path not maintained. Let's have a little look at the view. I've
go a little bit off the path. Look at that. It's a little bit tricky to walk around. But
it's like something out of Jurassic Park or something like that.
Just look at that. And listen to the little trickle of water.
Very, very sweet. Lovely place.
I actually totally didn't need to go off-road there. You just get the view from the path of that. It's great when there's no wind. Seems to be perfect temperature. And even on path not maintained, still a lovely path to jog along. I can still see my feet, see where they're landing. And it's soft ground, so it's not bad for the knees or the hips. Couldn't do it in a wheelchair, but certainly do it with a bit of sciatica. Oh, and just around Christmas trees. Whee! Ow, that was spiky.
This area, I think there's quite a few ultra marathons that go on in the Cairngorms once in a while. And I still don't understand them. Like a half marathon, like this is fun, this is an adventure. I don't have the need to go through the punishment and the pain of doing something like an ultra marathon at the moment. Yeah, anyway, the biggest motivator or the inspiration for me, the thing which I have in the back of my head at the moment is probably a random one. It's Charlie. Well, apart from the fact that it's like, awesome, I can actually walk again after like 10 months ago I could barely walk from one end of the maternity unit to the other while my wife was giving birth and my back was so sore. Like, apart from that, you know, which is like, whoa, awesome, I have life again. There's a little phrase or a speech by Charlie Chaplin. You probably weren't expecting that one there. In the film, or in his role as the great dictator, there's a bit where he talks about you men, you are don't give yourself to these machine men with machine minds, with machine hearts. You are not kettle, you are free to do what you want to do or something. Ooh, that's a dodgy bridge. And use that life. Use that freedom as a wonderful adventure. Life is a wonderful adventure. And be free. I'm so tired just now, I can't quite remember exactly what the words were. But the idea of life is a wonderful adventure. And that's what I'm enjoying just now. Like, this is a wonderful adventure. These are bits which I don't know if this path just ends up in the middle of the loch, or if it's going to start pouring with rain, or anything like that. So I'm really enjoying doing this for the adventure, for the scenery, for the views, for the bit of extra life it gives you. The whole idea of doing like ultra marathons and the pain and suffering you do, mostly for the achievement of having done it. I'm like, totally, totally not fussed by that. But if it's the idea of having an awesome adventure, like recently I was watching a video, like this is path unmaintained. Right, I get it, that's a bit mean. Like recently I was watching a video about Mount Marathon over in America or Canada or something like that. And it's where there's a race up a mountain and it's a 3,000 foot incline all the way up, and then you have to come all the way back down. And I just like, turning that into a race is just the perfect way to ruin a lovely view, a lovely experience. You just see people getting up to the top, going around a flag, and then sprinting back downhill. You just kind of go, like, that sucks, does it not? It's like, where's the enjoyment in that, apart from, oh yay, I came 15th, you know? It's like, do stuff because you enjoy it, not because you just have to achieve something. Oh my god, like, this is total Ming Mong around here, not a big fat, right. This is where I'm totally lost now. Now, when I was on Map My Run, there was a path that kind of went that way. There seems to be no other path that goes that way. So I'm guessing, the path which I actually have to go is this.
This isn't a path, but I do see that there's some mountain bike tracks. So therefore, somebody's been here before. That's really weird ground. Weird earth. So yeah, this would be pretty tough to get through on a mountain bike. Never mind just on feet, but... right, around the corners. And into the rabbit run bit here. But yeah, this is like super path not maintained. Ow, ow! Like, really? This is the path? Like, totally not. But adventure cardio! Yeah! Ooh,
Seems to actually be running up a river, it seems like.
So it's like, here's the stream, and I'm just running in the puddles of the stream.
So I'll go off it. That's actually just marsh there, so that's not cool. Yeah, something with long distance running, adventure cardio. Gonna have to get used to just having wet feet. Oh God, it's so wet. Oh, so muddy as well. Can actually hear my girly whimpers. Oh my God, lost my shoe. As I was saying just before I lost my shoe there, I could hear my girly whimpers echo.
And apart from it just being paradise just now, let's see if you can hear my echo. Ah! That was pretty cool. Here again. Ah!
That's cool. That's cool. I like echoes.
Ah, is this not just paradise? Bliss? Beautifulness? All we need is to kill every single fly, and then it's just even more perfect. I would understand it if they were midges, but they're just flies. They don't, like, midges are at least trying to suck your blood. These guys, look at them. These guys just are just flying just to be motivating. That's what they are, but just like, they're not even landing on me to suck my sweat or anything. They're just like, just having nibbles, weirdos.
So I'm just on a logging track just now,
but I like how even on the logging track, they do give you instructions.
So that way is Dalnavert, which if I go that way, I then just hit road. But this way is the Feshy Bridge, and then that's kind of road as well, but at least I avoid a little bit more of road. But just when the sun's out and you've got to breathe it in, the smell of pine. The smell of these trees here. Oh, it smells so good. Yeah, I smell bad, but surroundings smell good.
However, there is then a sign saying no unauthorized persons beyond this point.
So even though this is a total path for me to get to Feshy Bridge, saying no unauthorized persons. I don't see anybody here. Nobody's gonna be like enforcing that rule. I don't think so. Just gonna see why. I'm gonna see why there's no unauthorized persons allowed. Do not climb on timber stacks. Okay, fine, won't do that. I think what it is if you're in a car rather than if you're just jogging or walking, because I think they just don't want, oh, it smells so good. I think they just don't want people stealing all the big logs that are down this path. Quite love logs. Just let it say, oh my God, they smell so good. Oh, I need to bottle that. Oh, that smells so lovely. Low flying plane, it's a glider.
It's a plane pulling the glider.
That's cool. So again, if you want to come to the Highlands, you can go gliding. And if you look down from the glider, you might see me running around lost in the trees. Awesome. And this is me back to that path which I was on this morning, where I cleverly said to myself, damn flies may be an issue.
Over my eyes to keep the goddamn flies away.
Hell yes, they're an issue. Well done, Dom. So that's just about 20 kilometers back to my starting position this morning, but not to the end. I've still got a little bit more to go. And that's me back out onto the main road, takes you around to Feshy Bridge. And that's me done. Half a marathon now. So, still the time. Let's see. Clock, it's almost 3 o'clock. Calories, lots. Time elapsed, 2 minutes 30, 2 minutes 29. However, as I've still got another like 3-4 kilometers to go, I'm going to keep on jogging them, so I'm not just going to walk it off. In case like the first K was not my fastest, then possibly Nike Plus might say that your best bit's your best bit. However, instead of following the road, oh, well, the other thing, knees aren't too bad. Just after, when I hit the road, my knee was like, oh, I feel a bit sore. But instead of following the road, I'm going to go, I was going to go this way, but this looks wet and super dangerous now. But check this path. And this is Feshie Bridge. So I've jogged past this a couple of times in previous videos. And this is what it looks like in summertime. Lots of fresh rain, mountain rainwater coming off there. And then on the other side, I really, really want to jump in there. I'll still be incredibly, incredibly cold, but it's just so picturesque, Feshie Bridge. Just look at that. However, still to go, still got distance to go. Now, the bit which I'm about to show you is where it gets really weird. You know how I was saying there's not many kind of weird things to show, but look at this. Look at this sculpture. How creepy. Like there's a hand up there with a book and yeah, that's pretty weird. And then there's more. Which, if you didn't know any better, or if you came into this area from a slightly different angle, you'd be like, what the hell have I just come across? It's like Scottish totem poles of weirdness. And then totally something out of a horror sci-fi film going on there. Like a head with an upside down tree, weird hands. Yeah, if you want nightmares, head to the Feshie Bridge sculpture trail. Fun. And that's me totally on the home stretch coming into Kincraig near Loch Inch Water Sports. So done 23 kilometers, and I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to walk the last. I don't need to go any faster. Oh, sounds like there's an event going on over here. Oh, there's a serious event going on here. Hold on, what's this? Yeah, that's maybe been going on for 2 hours 45 minutes. That's long enough, and it looks like there's like a serious scout camp thing going on in the field here. Lots of tents, army training stuff, scouts or a school. It'd be pretty awesome if your school brings a tent as big as that. But yeah, I don't think it's like an official event for me to just join in. Maybe you should try. Coming up to 24 kilometers there, and that's me just coming over the Kincraig Bridge. It makes you look out to Loch Inch, and a lovely sight to finish off your run with over there. Whoa, holy crap, almost fell through. Over there, Osprey Island, over that way, the south, and over there, Kincraig Stores. And we'll call that a day. Nice. Definitely when you slow down, you really feel pooped after that. So, in total, 24 kilometers, 300 meters, 2 hours, 58 minutes. So pretty much, yeah, that was a 3-hour jog with a good bit of blogging and adventuring and not knowing exactly where it's going. What I would say is it was lovely. It was mostly downhill. And I'd recommend that to anyone who was thinking about doing, hey, I want to do a half marathon. Oh, I might not be able to do it very well. Here's a great one, which is mostly downhill and in beautiful scenery. The only downside, the annoying flies all the way. So be prepared for that. Buffs definitely help. going to try and jog and eat rice cakes like a boss. This is where it's all the flows are.
And it's absolutely soaked, which maybe... I think I'll go along path not maintained.
And it's, the cold water's on my balls.
Legit, that is so pretty! That is so pretty!
My god, like this is total Ming Mong.
It's kind of like a cozy blanket.
Oh my god! Oh, I lost my shoe! Ah.
You'd be like, what the hell have I just come across?
Guys, look at them! Oh my god, they smell so good!
No unauthorized persons beyond this point.
Faster, go! Apart from that, you know, which is like, whoa, awesome! I have life again.